Hi there, I'm David Lee from BASSBOSS, and sometimes you just don't have that much power available. So we're going to answer the question, how much system or what systems can you run on a 20 amp or 15 amp circuit if that's all you got? The answer to the question in terms of the BASSBOSS gear is most of them, but really the amount of power you have available is really related to how much volume you can get, how loud you can get, because they'll run up to a point on 120 volts, 20 amps. You're not drawing current from the wall to get the system on. It's related to how loud it gets. The real question that I'm going to answer is, can I turn the system all the way up? What system can I turn all the way up on a single circuit? The amplifiers we use in our subwoofers are intentionally very efficient. They do waste very little power, but they do produce a lot of power, and the power doesn't come from nowhere, so it does have to come out of the wall. So if you have a single circuit available, and let's begin by talking about a single, what I call a grid circuit, which is to say a circuit that's coming from the power grid, the commercial grid, not from a little generator. You can run two of our subwoofers and two of our tops on a single 20 amp circuit. You can run them, if it's a solid 20 amp circuit, it's not old and weak and it doesn't have 300 feet back to the panel, you can run that much gear at what is effectively full power. The reason you can do that, even though it's theoretically more than the circuit breaker can provide, is because the amplifiers don't draw the demand for power constantly. It's a variable load, so it's peaks, 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 and the average is below that maximum 20 amp with music, even with compressed, produced, and turned up music. It's usually not saturated more than about 12% on average. That said, when you have one of those big drops with a long bass note, it will pull the maximum. This is the point at which you can limit out. The amplifiers have current limiters. They also have output limiting based on the voltage. If there's voltage sag and it's not getting what it needs, it'll back down. So it'll do its best. The amplifiers will do their best to minimize the likelihood of a circuit breaker tripping, even when you've got them turned up. Whatever combination of subs and tops that you have from BASSBOSS, you can run those on a single 20 amp circuit. If you have a double driver sub, an SSP218 or a ZV28, you can still run them, but bear in mind they won't be able to get to full power and you might trip the breaker. The advantage and disadvantage in that case is that you will get the same amount, if not maybe a little bit more, absolute sound pressure level output from the double driver subs running on that 20 amp circuit than from the single driver subs drawing more on that circuit, but they have the capacity. They're closer to the point where if you do turn them up too much, they could trip the breaker. So bear that in mind when you're setting that up and just keep the level down. I mean, one thing you can try that it's not necessarily going to cause any harm, not to the equipment anyway, is to play as loud as you dare, and if the breaker doesn't trip, then you are pretty much, you've got enough to do what you need to do. So that's kind of a rule of thumb in general. I mean, if the breaker trips, you lose sound. It's better to know that before the show starts than it is to be all into it and then, oh, where'd the sound go? So test first. If a breaker trips, do it far enough ahead of the show that anything that you do during that testing phase isn't going to heat the breaker up. Because the older breakers in particular, there's some newer ones that don't use heat as much, but breakers will trip when they get warmer. So the more you get close to the edge of their capacity, and the hotter they get, the closer they are to being tripped. So when they're cold, they will pass more current than when they're hot. And so that's also something to bear in mind. If you're out in some hot environment and the circuit breaker sitting in the sun, you won't be able to get as much through it, most likely, if it's a heat sensitive breaker. Hopefully that will help you utilize the systems to their maximum capacity and keep the party rolling. Thanks.